friend Dusty Moore from up here in Knightstown, Indiana. It's November 2009. And I was channel surfing the other day, and I came across this concert where my old high school buddy, Danny Toler, and along with Dickey Betts and the Great Southern Band were playing a concert at the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame in Cleveland, Ohio in 2005. Well, I just couldn't help but record it, and for many reasons it was cool to be able to see them play and, you know, see them play and hear them at the same time. So I thought I'd send this out to some of my buddies and share it with you. Danny, I'm going to give you a little background. Danny Toler and I went to Connersville High School. He was 1 year younger than me. And he came to me when he was probably a junior, and I was probably a senior. And he said, "Hey man, I heard you took piano lessons." And I said, "That's right." He said, "Well, I'm starting this band, and I need a organ player in my band." I said, "Well, I've never done anything like that." He said, "Come on over to practice, and we'll see what happens." Well, anyway, I went over there. And he said, "Okay, we're going to play High Heel Sneakers in the Key of C." I said, "Where's the sheet music?" So anyway, he said, "Well, we don't play by sheet music." I said, "Well, I don't know how to play by ear." Well, anyway, we went on, and he showed me how to play some chords and stuff. And we played for a couple months together there, and then everybody knew Danny. He was a genius, musical genius for a kid. And he, one of his things about this concert is that he's wearing a black shirt, and on this black shirt, if you'll notice it, there's a little flying V guitar. And he played a flying V guitar because of this guy right here, Lonnie Mack, which was from our area in Indiana. He's from down around Aurora near the river there. And Lonnie used to come up to Connersville, because Connersville is a pretty big town for southeast Indiana. And he'd do concerts around at the different clubs, and, you know, Eagles and, the Armory and stuff like that. And Danny met him and learned a lot from him. So in this band, we played all these songs I'd never heard of before. Where were they from? This album right here, Lonnie Mack. And you'll notice on the front that Lonnie Mack played a flying V. So there is no doubt in my mind that the reason Danny wore that shirt for this concert at the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame was because of that man right there, Lonnie Mack. And you know, it's a shame, it's really a shame that there's not some type of tribute to Lonnie Mack down there in southeast Indiana, because he was truly a legend. And I don't know, maybe there already is, but anyway, I'm sure that little flying V on Danny's shirt is in because his mentor, Lonnie Mack, did that. You know, years later, we didn't know it then, but Danny and I found out we were related back to a family named the Bowmans back in Kentucky. Same family, I don't know, back six generations back, but the bloodline came right down to both of us. It's pretty cool. And Lonnie Mack is, the Mack is short for McIntosh. And there were a million McIntoshes down there in our area of Kentucky. And it would not surprise me if somewhere along in there, Lonnie Mack is kin to us too. Anyway, I'm going to send this out to some of my friends. And I'm going to try to get a copy down there to Lonnie Mack, because I think he needs to know that Danny wore that shirt at that kind. He's playing. Danny's playing the lead right here. But you know, if I had to compare Dickey Betts and Danny Toler playing together. You'll love this whole band. They got a fantastic keyboard man. The bass player is really incredible, and the drummer is really solid. And of course, Danny and Dickey both play guitars, and they complement one another. They play rides that match one another, and they're beautiful. But if Dickey is the rough side, Danny is the smooth side, and you'll really like it. So, sit back, relax. The show's about 2 hours long, and you won't be able to quit till it's over. It's that good. Play that piano there, bud. He's good too. See y'all later. Have a good one.
So much the tune, it's the performance. If I do Elizabeth Reed tonight, it'll be a totally different experience than if you hear one of the Allman Brothers versions. You know, that's the only way you can play a lot of these songs for as long as I've been playing, too, is that they're not the same.
It's a very unique experience. There's an energy coming off of that guy that just spreads to the whole band, you know, it's great. When things start to feel a little too comfortable, he'll throw us a curve.
When this band came together, we really excite each other on stage and play really well together now, I feel, and better than ever before.
You know, we get to kind of grow as a unit as well as a band, and you get to really, you know, really play all you can. Especially for a bass player, it's a unique role because he really encourages the bass player not to just lay back and play the groove. He doesn't like to hear, you know, something, a repetitive phrase. He likes to hear someone who's really chasing the melody.
I kind of give direction. I don't tell anybody how to play. But if they're good enough to be in this band, then they're good enough to make a musical statement. I mean, the Hall of Fame, we really had lost words for that. It was really overwhelming.
It's awesome. This place is awesome. This is going to be... it's going to be killer.
I think the band's going to, you know, really blow the roof off the place.
It's what I do, man.
Yes, thank you very much.
She says she wanna go.